looks like for the second question, we've pulled up a question about finding the length of an arc length, intercepted by a central angle of pi over 6 radians. We have a radius of 19 centimeters. So what we've got is we've got a circle. We go out 19 centimeters. That's our radius. And our angle's pi over 6. Hopefully you remember that from the unit circle. It's 30 degrees, but that's, if you don't, that's fine. But that helps us in drawing it, pi over 6. And what we want is the arc, the length of the arc. That's this part here. And usually we call that S. And hopefully you remember the formula. S is equal to the radius times theta. It's just like that. So this is another formula you might want to add. We don't give you every single formula that you would need for trig, but this would be good to for your practice. Maybe I should have done this one too, but anyway, it's there. So the arc length is going to be 19 centimeters. That's its length. And times pi over 6. Now notice in the answer they don't give us a pi and they want it rounded to the nearest tenth. So when we do this we're going to need to use the calculator, and they do provide one here in I'll use the Alex calculator. So 19 times pi divided by 6, just like that. We hit enter and we're going to round that, so it's going to be 9.9. We look, there's a 4, so we don't go up, we stay down at 9.9. And that's in centimeters, so 9.9 centimeters is the length of that arc. Oh my, well, I'm noticing I'm in degrees. I just want to show you that that won't make any difference because I didn't take a sine or a cosine, but be careful when you're using radians. We should be in radians. Since the calculation was that way, we should be fine. But let me just redo it because I want you to remember about, well, not that, divided by 6. Let's go with equals, same number, but watch for that, whether you're in radian or degree mode. I tend to forget, so that's why I make a big deal out of it. All right, that's good. Number 2.